What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel, Rindex Grief Afro Groove Dance. Yeah. So today is gonna be a little bit different than usual. Today I'm gonna tell you how to dance, like how to dance. Now, first, before I get into that, okay. So, first of all, when you think about how to dance, what comes to your mind is just the movement of the body and portraying of movements. But have you ever thought of online places that can help you? Like Steezy. Now, Steezy is a great place. They teach almost all types of dance, from beginners to intermediates to advanced. Different types, almost all types of dance. Like any kind of dance you want to learn, you're going to learn easy on Steezy. Now, today's video is going to be short. I'm going to be as fast as I can because I want you guys to know everything. So now, before I go, I'm going to show you guys my videos from when I started dancing to this current time, and I'll ask you, what do you think? Do you see any change or anything you like? But before that, guess what? Yes, please subscribe, please like, comment, and share my video. Please share my video to all the people who you think love to dance and would love to really work as dancers professionally or just for fun. It's really important to me. Thank you so much. So now, how did I start dancing? Now, it wasn't okay, unlike some people, for me it was an imbued talent. It's always been in me, but I never ever just looked at it. And I wish I did, because I know I would have gone really far now. I just saw it as a plaything, a dreadful thing. So just as of lately, I took it professionally and I said, okay, I really wasted a lot of time. I should have been doing this a long time ago. Now, dancing for me is the second thing I love best after God. Like, I'm serious. After God, to me, it's dance. I love it. I dance almost every day. I even do special workouts for dance every morning when I wake up, because I want to get better. I don't want to have a status quo on dance. Now, so I'm going to tell you guys four things you must know if you want to be a dancer and you need anytime, any day. Four things. First of all, you have to be a creator. Now, when I say you have to be a creator, what I mean exactly is you have to know how to dance and stand out. You must try in your own possible way to be a trendsetter, or at least in your own possible way be different. Now, this may seem too hard for you if you're just learning dance and you can't dance before, but I just want you to know, if you ever take dance serious, you have to create. You have to work on yourself. You see, some big dancers are big because they went out of the box and created something. You understand? And be a creator. Let people know you for something. Have a signature that makes you different, that makes people want to always watch your videos. That is how to be a good dancer. Be a creator. Think, sit down, create ideas. And if you have the resources, like good cameras, good appliances for you to make good videos, make use of it to the fullest extent. And you're going to really go. Now, we have social media, we have Instagram, we have YouTube, we have Facebook. These platforms can help you just by you taking the real decision for yourself. You understand what I'm saying? That's one. Secondly is consistency. Now, I know a lot of us have had consistency on a lot of platforms and different places. Yes, life is about consistency. The reason why we have a Mark Zuckerberg today was because of consistency. The reason we have a Minnie Mouse today was because of consistency. Everything was born out of consistency. So you should know, consistency says, I won't give up. It says, I won't give up until I get it. It is not over until it is over. This is my assignment. I will not stop. That's what it means. You're looking at me now, I'm a big person. I have, you know, I'm not skinny or so fit. But then, yeah, in case you're thinking, yes, it was hard when I started dancing. Like, I had a lot of people that looked at me and were like, are you kidding me? Did you just bring this guy? Like, what can you do? Someone even asked me once, he said, do you gas out when you dance? And I was like, no. I said, no. But then I thought of it again. Who doesn't gas out when they dance? Like, it's energy you use when you dance. But because I was consistent and I knew what I wanted, at least to an extent, I have created some sort of respect for myself. Now, most in the dance community where I stay, I'm respected. People don't look at me and say, you can't do that now. How do you expect? Except they know it's out of my field. But when there are gigs I get called because of consistency. And consistency also works with humility. You have to be humble. If you're not humble at the beginning, even if you're talented, people will push you away because character says it all. The third thing you should know is find your genre. Now, your genre is very, 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 very important. You need to find your genre. That means, do you want hip-hop? Do you want locking? Do you want breaking? Do you want afro? Do you want house or afro house? All those things, you need to know. You have to have a specialty. You have to have one that's in your heart, that no bonds, and you want to do it. You have to have one. You can't tell me I love all styles of dances. It's a lie. Nobody's like that. No soul under the heavens can love all forms of dance and not have a special one. You have to find your special one. That's how you grow. I started with hip-hop, and then now I'm far away from hip-hop, and I'm an afro dancer. And the reason why I left hip-hop was because I like hip-hop more for its aesthetics. Like, it was beautiful to just watch someone dance, like dance hip-hop. But when I sat down and I wanted to be a creator, I found that it was hard for me. Like, I could hardly create because I was only replicating all I saw. I couldn't create. Now that I'm an afro dancer, I can create. I can say, no, I don't want to do this. It is too cliche. I want to do something else. I need to look beautiful. I have quite some videos that I need some moves that I'm sure I haven't seen anywhere. So you have to find your genre so you know what suits you best. That's how to be a dancer. And the last one is exposure. Now, exposure, I've said it already. Exposure has to do with your online self, your personality online, how you build yourself, how you show us who you are through it. It actually cuts across just dancing, cuts across your lifestyle, who you are. And exposure actually is what takes you out there, what makes other people find you. You try this is if you want to be a professional. If you don't want to be a professional, then the exposure is not so necessary, except you just want fans for nothing. You understand what I'm saying? But the exposure is actually important if you want to be a professional. So you have your phones, you have your mobile devices, make videos, post them, tag, hashtag. Now let me tell you something, hashtag is more important than tagging people, because in most cases, most celebrities will never, ever, ever, ever answer you except you do something way outstanding. You understand what I'm saying? So it's better to even hashtag than to tag. So put the right hashtags and the algorithm will push your videos, and then people start seeing it. Then you're exposed to everyone in the public. So that's what I need you guys to know. These four tips can help you to be a great dancer, can help you to work well. Now, if you ask me, these four tips, well, for me, basically, I'm working on them. My exposure level is good enough to an extent. I'm not so strong on the net, but I know I've made some connections.
Like you get when you dance, baby girl, you dig calypso. Baby girl, your body bad, oh. Up in the tempo, I like you when you dance, oh yeah. When you wine, oh.
Posted. I hope you saw how I moved from being just ordinary. I mean, sometimes when I watch my videos, I'm laughing because I'm like, ew, rubbish. Now look at it now. See, you could see the progress, how I got better. It was due to consistency. So I hope you like this video and comment and share this video to whichever friend you have that also wants to be a dancer, because you need it. If you don't have these four tips, it's never going to work out for you. Thank you.